Ford, America's best-selling brand. Just announced, get a Ford F-Series with 0% financing for 72 months, plus $1,000 smart bonus cash on specially tagged trucks, or choose up to $10,500 total savings. Call 877-4002 or log on to NewEnglandFord.com for details. Sales claim based on 2015 calendar year sales.
Dale and Holly, Monday at 2 on WEEI.
It is a gorgeous night for baseball, an hour later than we're normally accustomed to. It's to accommodate the national television broadcast tonight on Sunday Night Baseball. Eduardo Rodriguez makes his first start since his outstanding start that he had, but it was only for four innings on the 16th at Baltimore. He had a no-hitter going when he felt a twinge in the leg, something that was cramping a little bit, a slight hamstring issue, but he is back. And as John Farrell told Joe Castiglione during the manager's report tonight, that he is free and clear to go and should have no restrictions whatsoever as he takes on this Kansas City Royals lineup. Royals 67-62. The Royals start the night in the Central Division, still trailing the Detroit Tigers. Cleveland Indians, the top team in the AL Central. Toronto won today. Josh Donaldson with three home runs, helping the Blue Jays defeat Minnesota once again. Baltimore also beat the Yankees. So the Red Sox will start this one officially a game and a half behind Toronto. Getting set for the first pitch of the ballgame is Kansas City center fielder Paulo Orlando will step into the batter's box, and E-Rod getting set to go. And with the play-by-play, back from an outstanding wedding in the Castiglione family, is Joe Castiglione.
Thank you so much, Tim Neverett. I'd like to send along congratulations to my nephew Rich Coasen and his bride, the former Jen Rappaport. Congratulations on their wedding yesterday at the Four Seasons in Boston. And much happiness. That's a former Harvard hockey player. First pitch of the ball game is low and away, ball one. Paulo Orlando, three for his last 35, but still hitting 309 with four homers, 27 RBI, 73 degrees, and very comfortable here. Clear skies, the pitch. In there for a call strike. This is the final meeting between these two clubs scheduled this year. Royals have won three, the Red Sox two. E-Rod, first pitch in the heat of battle since August 16th. The next one is swung on, fisted on the ground, weakly to short, charge. Bare hands by Xander, fires and gets him. He's so good with that bare hand play. Orlando can run, and he got the Brazilian-born center fielder. 6-3 on the out, scooping it with a bare hand. Had he gone to the glove, he would have had to use a backhand and might have been another beat before he could have released it, and that could have made the difference. He still got him by two steps. One down for Chester Cuthbert, the third baseman from Nicaragua, hitting a 292 with 10 homers. And that's in there for a call strike. Fastball in there. E-Rod misses in tight with a fastball. He's won his only career decision against Kansas City. That was last year. First two batters, they have hitters from countries that don't produce many major leaguers. Brazil, very rare, and Nicaragua. Most from Nicaragua have been pitchers. Inside, 2-1. Cuthbert has really helped them out considerably since they lost Moustakas with an ACL operation. Ground ball weakly to third. Charge there. Bare hand throw by Hill wide. Another top ground ball, or Shaw, I should say, firing it on the move. And Travis did all he could. But an infield hit. That brings up Lorenzo Cain, who's hitting 288, nine homers. He's knocked in 53. Playing extremely well in right field, as he used to in center field. First inning presented by Volvo. Get everything you want this summer and more from Volvo for a limited time. And making the premier package complimentary, visit your local Volvo dealer for details. A-Rod working from the set with that red glove up by his chin. He delivers and misses up and away. Ball one. Just made some very good pitches. Two weak grounders, but one was so weak that Cuthbert got an infield hit out of it. Here's the 1-0 deal. And Kane takes it low and away. Kane was on the DL earlier. The Royals really struggled without him. A hamstring issue. And after that, they moved him to right field from center to cut down on some of the stress and the running. And it's helped some. Orlando's done a very good job in center, sharing it with Dyson. 2-0 pitch. Pop foul to the right out of play. Bell Insurance Foundation is the proud presenting sponsor of the WEEI message. Jimmy Fund Radio Telethon starting tomorrow and going through Tuesday. They're dedicated to striking out cancer in kids. They donate $50 for every strikeout from a Red Sox pitcher. Check out the Bell Insurance tote board at WEEI.com. Bell Insurance here for the Jimmy Fund, here for good.
Going to be a busy next couple of days, Joe.
Yes, indeed. 6 to midnight, Monday and Tuesday, 6 a.m. to midnight, our Jimmy Fund radio telephone, the pitch. And a pop foul to the right out of play. We'll be with you tomorrow night after the game through midnight. Dave Roberts is going to join us tomorrow, a little before 3:30 on the flagship with Dale and Holly. And talk to Dave when we were out there with the Dodgers. And he's got his team in first place now.
And they're rolling a little bit, too.
Indeed. A big lift from Rich Hill to beat the Giants. The pitch is taken high. Rich has turned the pitch tomorrow. Dodgers beat the Cubs today 1-0. And the Giants won, so it's still a two-game lead for L.A. Dave Roberts, a great communicator, has really done a good job with that team. 3-2 pitch. Hit in the air to right center field. Shallow. On comes Mookie and Jackie, too. Mookie calls and grabs it. Jackie crossing behind him. A soft out. Two now for Eric Hosmer. Who's at 274 with 18 homers. He's knocked in 76. Hosmer had a three-run homer in the first inning of game one off right. Royals are 67-62. Now, if they win, they will be 5.5 behind Cleveland, which lost today to Texas. Could pick up a game on the Yankees and move ahead of them. But there's a lot of teams that jump over in the wild card, the pitch. Swinging strike. Right now, they'd have to jump over Detroit, Houston, Seattle, and New York.
A lot can still happen. I mean, we've got a month and 2 days remaining in the season after tonight. And still, some crazy things happen. Sometimes it comes down to the last day.
Here's the pitch. Low and inside. That's why every game the last day starts at 3:05. Whatever time zone you're in, 3:05 Eastern time.
That's so that another team can't pull their starting pitcher that is ready to go. In the event something would happen in an earlier game out east.
See, the teams in front of them all lost today. Houston, Detroit, Yankees, low and inside. Not Baltimore, because Baltimore beat the Yankees. Seattle lost as well. So this is a big one for the Royals. They'll get home about 4 to 5 in the morning, if all goes well. And then host the Yankees tomorrow night. They have a three-game set with the Yankees. 2-1 to Hosmer, left-hand batter. Takes low and inside. This is the only game still in progress. He rides 3-1. And he takes inside ball four. He missed two straight sinking pitches there. Took a little something off the fastball there. Runners at first and second now. And here's Kendrys Morales, a switch hitting DH. 244 with 20 homers. He's knocked in 58. So a key spot here for Erod. Pitching for the first time in 12 days. Just heard from Dave Roberts after his win over the Cubs today, confirming his appearance on our radio telethon tomorrow. Dodgers are going to Colorado. Sandy Leon out for a brief conference. All Venezuelan battery for the Red Sox tonight. Erod and Sandy. Morales is from Cuba. A check of the runner is the pitch. And it runs away, ball one. Toronto selling out just about every game, mid-40s attendance. A big one today for Josh Donaldson, the pitch, low and away. Hit three home runs. And being in Canada with a hat trick, there were all kinds of hats thrown on the field after that third homer.
They collected them and presented them to him after the game in a couple of big garbage bags full of hats.
Trey found one he liked. 2-0. Low ball, 3. They really haven't been close. That was 95. So 21 pitches this inning, only 8 strikes. So he's showing a little rust. Cuthbert at second. Hosmer at first. Here it is. And a ground ball pull foul. He got the green light, pulled it by the third base dugout and topped it. It was 96 on the gun. Cuthbert and Hosmer lead away, and Erod with a 3-1 pitch. Here it is. Swinging a high pop-up, shallow right field. Mookie's coming in. He's there and makes the catch in shallow right to retire the side. Erod leaves, too, after half an inning. Royals nothing. Red Sox coming up on the Shaws.
Yo, WEEI.
Tonight at Shaw's, enjoy the taste of summer with 5 to 6 ounce California raspberries or blackberries. Simply $1.88 each at Shaw's, official supermarket of the Red Sox Radio Network. Rodano Ventura, fastball averages close to 96 miles an hour on the mound. And he will face leadoff hitter Brock Holt. In case you're just joining us, Dustin Pedroia is away tonight due to a death in his family. Lots of prayers go out to Dustin and his family. Holt hitting 252, 6 homers, 29 RBIs, the pitch. And it's low ball one. Xander Bogaerts to follow, then David Ortiz. Royals are only 27 and 41 on the road. It's been their undoing. The 1-0, and that dips low from the hard-throwing righty at 97. And sure, it can be wild, sometimes effectively wild, sometimes scary. 2-0 to Holt. And a strike, borderline pitch over the inside edge.
Well, he's been good in August. He's 3-0 in August, but back in July, he went 0-4. So there are 3 wins in August and 1 win in July since the All-Star break.
And Holt takes low ball 3. Last year, he went 13-8. And actually was farmed out for 2 starts at Omaha. Came back well in the postseason. Was 0-2. Pitch. Strike called right in there. That was 98. That was an easy 98. Year before 14-10, and this year 9-9. It's been an up and down year. Not very big, 6'1", 185, 3'2", is fisted into center field. It's dropping fast, and it's in there for a hit. Holt fought it off. And hit a high fastball at 97 directly over second base in a shallow center. So here comes Xander. There's five of his last nine. He's back to 310, 16 homers, 74 RBIs, and 162 hits.
I talked about one of the keys is that Holt's going to fit into that spot as a table setter tonight. Did just that in his first at bat. And Xander looks like he's got to swing back.
He's 2-for-10 against this pitcher. Ventura turned 25 in June from the Dominican Republic. The Royals signee pitch taken high. Working on a 5-year contract now. And he's hitting 340 at home. So Holt being held on by Eric Hosmer, a Gold Glover at first. And the 1-0 swing. There's a line drive to right field, but right there is Kane to grab it. Now, Kane was positioned perfectly, fairly close to the line, and he took about five steps to his left and grabbed that bullet.
You see Xander starting to use the whole field again. Last night he had a ground rule double that bounced over the wall near the pesky pole. Here he tries to go the other way. Pretty hot shot, but Kane had it played right.
So here's Poppy. Hitting 319, 30 homers, 100 RBIs. Third in RBIs, leading in doubles with 41. And leading in extra base hits as well. And the first one misses ball one. Poppy with 72 extra base hits. No shift on. They don't shift as much as some clubs. And the pitch taken outside, especially in double play situations. The third baseman playing halfway to second, but otherwise, second baseman Mondesi's in a conventional spot. Now with a count 2-0, the shortstop Escobar moves a couple of steps to the right of second base, but nobody on the outfield surface with a runner at first. Here comes a 2-0. And he rips a bullet on one hop. Stab by Mondesi. Fires to the shortstop. Out on the first. Double play. Paid off. That ball was hit so hard. And he's thrown out more base dealers. 26 than anybody in Major League Baseball this year. Here's the pitch. And it's a long drive to left. If it's fair, it's gone down the line. Hooking. And it's a home run. Just inside the pole in the last row of the monster seats, 1-0 Kansas City. Might have even touched the pole going by. His third home run in two games. Salvi Perez. I think you'd have to call him the best catcher in the game today.
I think as far as his offense goes, there's no question. And, of course, he's a good defensive catcher, throws the ball well.
Perennial Gold Glove winner.
But this has been an issue for Erod this year, giving up the home runs. That's his 14th home run given up at 14 starts.
Alex Gordon rips a base hit. First ball swinging into right. He pulled an inside pitch, a slider between first and second. So Gordon is heating up after a tough start and a long stint on the DL. Went up there at 227 with 14 homers. And still nobody out. And it's Escobar, the shortstop, who's at 265 with three homers. Back-to-back first pitch swings here. So he's thrown two pitches in the second inning, giving up a long home run. And now a solid single. Escobar is the league leader in sacrifices with 10. And Shaw is close at third, but he takes a call strike. So Erod's now giving up three hits and a walk. The 0-1 pitch. Fastball riding outside. Tonight at Shaw's, 8-ounce Lucerne shredded bar or deli-style sliced cheese, just 99 cents each, limit of four, Shaw's official supermarket of the Red Sox Radio Network. Here comes 1-1. That runs down and away. He's not had good command yet to his fastball in particular. Praying Mantis is in the dugout again.
Well, they've got him caged up. Perez went over, picked up the cage, and kissed it after the home run.
Foul to the right, out of play. He's hit three the last two nights combined. He's got some tropical foliage in that cage.
Well, they didn't have that for the first one, and he died. They needed to figure out how to make one survive, so they made the right environment for him, I guess.
2-2. That skips in there. Short hop by Sandy, who knocks it down. Already 30 pitches for A-Rod. One inning plus two batters. Escobar, last year's ALCS MVP. And the payoff pitch. And he takes low ball four. Two men on, nobody out. Let's check in with Christian Arcand.
Thanks, Joe. The Red Sox cannot claim a share of first place in the East tonight thanks to the Blue Jays, who came back to beat the Twins. 9-6, your final score. Jays trailed in this one 5-2 in the sixth inning, but Josh Donaldson just too much. Three home runs for the third baseman. Jays complete a three-game sweep. The Orioles avoided a sweep in the Bronx today, blanking the Yankees 5-0. Mark Trumbo hit a home run, his 40th of the year.
Royals still last in runs scored. Here's Raul Mondesi, has been slumping at 184 with a homer, seven RBIs. And the Red Sox are looking bunt at first and third for this switch hitter, who has outstanding speed. Shaw at the cut of the grass at third, and Hanley well in on the grass at first. Royals have 33 sacrifices as a team. Here's the pitch. He squares. He bunts third base side, a beauty. Shaw has to go to first, and they just do get the speedster. 5-3 on the out, 5-4 on the out with Holt taking the throw. Beautiful sacrifice bunt by Raul Mondesi, the 21-year-old.
Now he did it right, put it down third base, made Shaw field it with runners at first and second. You want to make the third baseman field it. And he got great speed, too, as you mentioned, but did a lot of things right there. That was a very well-executed sack bunt.
5-4 on the out, his sixth sacrifice. So Gordon at third and Escobar at second for Paolo Orlando. And the Red Sox bring the infield in here in the early going. Orlando bounced out 6-3, his first time up in a 3-for-36 slump. A-Rod deals, and there's a line drive to center. Jackie going back. He's going to make the catch, but plenty deep to score a run. And also to advance Escobar to third. Gordon crosses the plate easily. Throw to the middle of the diamond. It's 2-0. A sack fly for Orlando, his 28th RBI, and it's 2-0 Royals. That was hit very hard. So A-Rod, again, paying for a walk. Two men down, and here is Cuthbert, who had an infield hit his first time up, but was stranded at second. And he takes a cutter, low ball one. Christian?
Over in Houston, Joe, Chris Archer did something he hasn't done much this year, and that's win a game. 10 strikeouts and 7 innings for the righty. He improves to 8-17. Rays win big 10-4. Your final from Minute Maid Park. Xfinity X1 will change the way you experience TV. Track live scores right on your TV and easily switch between games with the sports app. Joe?
All right, thank you. That one low, 2-0. So 35 pitches and only 16 strikes. That won't keep him in the game very long.
No, he's just not executing his pitches. A lot of them are low. One he left up ended up off the foul pole in left field. And a very key walk this inning.
There's a swinging strike. Slider at 90, 2-1.
Now, when you look at what Erod has done prior to the game here tonight in his career, short career, but in his career, he's limited the opposition to a 157 average with two outs and runners in scoring position, only 11 out of 70 against him. And typically, even with less than two outs and runners in scoring position, he's been pretty stingy.
He gets a swinging strike and a high fastball there at 95. Reaching back for a little extra there, 2-2.
But the Red Sox really counting on Rodriguez. They were this year. Got hurt in spring training. Came back late. And ended up struggling. Went down to the minor leagues. Came back. Missed his last start.
Here's the pitch. A little high with a heater. So another full count. Salvi Perez now with a 20 home run season after his leadoff homer here in the second. Escobar third, two down. The payoff pitch coming to Cuthbert. And he swings and misses at a high fastball. So he threw four straight fastballs and got him swinging. Side retired after 1.5, 2-0 Kansas City on the Shaw's WEEI Red Sox Radio Network. 74. Ventura delivers. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. A big slow curve at 82. His fastball is 97 and 98. And the 0-1, Mookie swings and misses. Threw him another off-speed pitch down and away. Tentative cut there at another curve. And the 0-2, foul off the catcher. Perez, I think, on the hand. He's looking at his fingers. Well, he is a big target back there, about 6'5", 240. And World Series MVP last year, the pitch. There's a looping line drive in the center. Actually, a low line drive. Might have kicked off second base. Goes into center field, a base hit. Number 175 for Mookie in the hit column. Second hit off Ventura. Nice easy swing here after he fell behind in the count. And he hit a low shot that touched the bag going through. Here's Hanley now, 277, hit his 17th homer last night. He has 78 RBIs. Two hits for the Red Sox, a double play. Ended the first inning. And Mookie being held on by Hosmer. Ventura deals. Low and away. Ball one. Cumberland Farms celebrating their 99-cent any size coffee. You can win $99,999 if the Red Sox hit a grand slam off the 99th pitch they face. And over at CumberlandFarms.com, Cumberland Farms official coffee of the Red Sox Radio Network. A 1-0. Had a bounding ball hit toward the middle. It's Escobar stepping on the bag, throwing to first. Another double play. 6-3. Two double plays in two innings. And now Travis Shaw, who homered off Ventura at Kansas City, hitting 247 with 14 homers. Complete the Safe Light Auto Glass part of the order. Remember, when that is 3 through 6, homer, Safe Light donates $200 to the Make-A-Wish Foundation of Massachusetts. Ventura deals and misses low and inside. And a swinging strike and a pitch down and away. A changeup. His changeup is 88.
Quick for a changeup, but he throws fast.
There's a call strike over the inside corner. The 1-2. And that one's low. Two balls, two strikes.
Yeah, Ventura possesses the strength to throw the ball 100 miles an hour, typically throw in the high 90s. But at times the Royals have urged him to worry about more control than power, throwing it through a brick wall. That has gotten him in trouble in the past.
2-2, his last foul into the State Street Pavilion third base side.
Yeah, that one 99 miles an hour.
Ventura has given up 20 home runs this year. Here's 2-2 to Travis. And that's an off-speed pitch low. 90-mile-an-hour changeup. Well, it is 8 miles off his fastball. Here comes the payoff. And he pokes a foul past third base coach Brian Butterfield. Almost drove a security guard down there. So another 3-2 pitch upcoming with two down and the bases empty. The pitch. And he walked him, ball four, missed low. So Travis patiently working a walk to another 89 mile an hour change up there. So that brings up Chris Young, 0 for his last seven. Hitting 268, six homers, he's knocked in 16. Young getting his first look at Ventura. Here's the pitch, and it's wide, ball one. Two nothing Royals, last of the second. And a fastball, a little low.
Chris drew a couple of walks last night and scored both times he walked. He walked in the second inning and walked in the fourth inning last night.
Ventura has hit six batters this year. Sometimes they cause problems for him, low and inside.
That caused problems for him in early June when he hit Manny Machado of the Baltimore Orioles. Caused a melee, and that resulted in originally a 9-game suspension. He appealed and dropped it and took an 8-game suspension instead.
So he's falling behind 3-0 after walking Shaw. And Young takes a strike. It was 98, so he didn't let up. If Chris reaches, Sandy Leon would be next. 3-1 pitch. And a bouncing ball hit weakly to third over the bag. Grabbed by Cuthbert. Throws on the move. Safe. Cuthbert had a little difficulty digging it out of the glove. Took an extra half step. He bounced the throw. Hosmer dug it out, but Young beat it. That extra beat cost him. So an infield hit, and it brings up Sandy Leon with the tying runs on. Sandy is now 0 for 11 of late, hitting 349, seven homers, and he's knocked in 26.
Everybody goes into the down part. They go in peaks and valleys. Sandy's had a big peak this year, but it doesn't mean he's going to stay in the valley. I think he's finally figured some things out, earning himself the job as the number one catcher here with the Red Sox.
He's got a chance here to drive in a run. Runners lead at first and second. Ventura's pitch is wide, ball one. So he's not been a strike thrower either. 31 pitches, only 16 strikes. Pitcher's a little off target. The Royals have scored two runs. Here's the pitch. And there's a call strike. Hope you'll be lighting up here about a tote board tomorrow over at Jimmy Fund WEI Nesson Radio Telethon, 6 a.m. to midnight. The 1-1 pitch. Low, nice stop by Perez on a pitch in the dirt. The number, if you want it to record it, to write it down, 877-738-1234. Or you can text K Cancer to 20222 to donate $25. Or go to jimmyfund.org. The 2-1 deal. And a high fly left field, but it's not going to carry. Gordon, in front of the track, by a few steps, makes the catch, and the Red Sox strand two.
Two runs on the board against him, including a home run by Salvi Perez in the second. First pitch missing low for ball one to Lorenzo Cain. Cain flied to right in the first inning. So 0 for 1 in the game for Cain, who's hitting 287, 9 home runs, 53 runs batted in. And the pitch now over the outside corner for a called strike. Just a little bit of a breeze blowing out to left field on a room temperature kind of night here at Fenway Park. Pitch right down the middle, good for a strike. And a little bit up in the zone, but certainly caught plenty of plate. And it's a one ball, two strike count to the right fielder, Kane. The wind of the pitch, a little high with a fastball at 95, 2-2. Jackie Bradley Jr., center fielder, a few steps over toward right center field. Mookie Betts not very deep in right. As Erod looks in at Sandy Leon, has the sign, Rodriguez pitch. Swung on, fouled back to the screen. Count stays 2 balls and 2 strikes. Rodriguez has done pretty well against the Central in his career. This is his 10th start against an American League Central Division team. He's 4-1 in his previous 9 starts with a 2.91 ERA. Ball is line foul out of play, just past Canvas Alley on the first base side. Count still 2-2. And in 2 career outings prior to tonight against Kansas City, Rodriguez 1-0 with a 2.19 ERA. So he's pitched fairly well, rather, against this Royals team. Red Sox have done well against the Royals as a team. Pretty high winning percentage against Kansas City in recent years. 2-ball, 2-strike pitch from Erod. And it's inside and backing way up to get out of the way is Kane. That fills the count up at 3-2. In fact, the Red Sox have the American League's best winning percentage against the Royals since the start of 2014. 12-7 against them, winning 63% of the time. 3-2 pitch, a bounding ball toward the hole on the left side of the infield. Grabbed by Shaw, he throws to first to get him. And there is one out. Tonight at Shaw's, value packs of delicious Smithfield country-style pork are just 99 cents per pound. Shaw's, the official supermarket of the Boston Red Sox radio network. So Kane is out, 5-3. Eric Hosmer, the batter. Hosmer homered in the first inning in game one Friday night here. Royals had a 5-run first inning against Stephen Wright. They held on to that. Hosmer, quick comebacker to Rodriguez, and that's 2 quick outs. 1-3 on the putout. Kendrys Morales, the switch hitting designated hitter, coming up. League leaders brought to you by Massachusetts General Hospital Cancer Center. Mookie Betts still remains among the league leaders in a number of categories, including total bases, 306. Next closest, Manny Machado with 286 for Baltimore. Jose Altuve third, also with 286. Pitch to Morales, low and away, ball one. Josh Donaldson leading in runs scored. He scored at least 3 today, so he's at 105. The pitch swung on, and a ball hit off the leg of Erod. He picks it up, left of the mound, throws on to first, low, and Hanley can't dig it out. But Erod took the ball off a leg. It glanced over toward third. He raised his hand up to tell Travis Shaw, I got it. Went and picked it up and threw low. And now with 2 outs, Morales is aboard. So a tough play two ways. Rodriguez seems okay. Might have got him on his cleat. A tough play because the pitcher got hit and then did not get the out.
They still charge an error, though.
Yeah, they'll charge an error on the throw. So an E1. First error of the ball game, and it's charged to Eduardo Rodriguez. Salvador Perez, 1-for-1 with a home run. Had two of them last night, one tonight. So he is swinging a very good bat for Kansas City. Rodriguez towing the rubber on the third base side. He's got Morales at first base, held on by Hanley. Second baseman Holt shading the bag and the pitch. And Morales takes a strike right at the knees. Every day, every moment, holds the opportunity for something amazing to happen. That's Mass General Hospital Cancer Center. Every day amazing. Visit massgeneral.org/playball for cancer. The 0-1 pitch. And he pulls it foul off the netting in front of the dugout on the third base side. It's 0-2. A slider he turned around on. Two outs, a man aboard. 2-0 Kansas City. Royals batting in the top of the third inning. Red Sox will have Jackie Bradley Jr. leading off the bottom of the third, then back to the top of the order. Jackie for the second straight game, hitting in the nine spot. And the pitch. Just missed off the outside edge. Borderline pitch that went Perez way. Ball of two strikes to the Kansas City catcher. E-Rod with a high set. Glove up by his face. Kicks and delivers. That's up high in the count 2-2. Certainly he's got to keep an eye on the pitch count. Up to 54, 28 strikes. So Perez. Homering off left-handers. His last three home runs have come off lefties. He swings and skies one to shallow left. Backpedaling is Bogarts. He's called off by Chris Young. He'll make the catch. And that'll retire the side. No runs, no hits. One error, one left after two and a half. It's the Royals 2, Red Sox nothing. On the Shaw's WEEI Red Sox.
Your New England Chevy dealer today. Call 888-59-CHEVY for vehicle and offer details. Geico brings you endorsements from the Pinch Runner.
I'm the Pinch Runner. When it comes to running 127 feet, 3 3/8 inches, I'm the go-to man who coach never goes to. Sure, I see game time from the dugout, because if I'm on the field, it's to grab a foul ball and toss it to some kid in the stands. My RBIs are TBD, but I did save money by switching to Geico, and while they hit it out of the park on my car insurance, the only thing I'll be hitting is the showers. Maybe.
Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
I'm Dr. Evan Schumer of Newton Wellesley Orthopedic Associates. If a hand injury is keeping you on the sidelines, NWOA can help. Call us at 617-964-0024 or NWOA.com. NWOA, expert care made easy.
Red Sox Baseball, 93.7 WEEI-FM.
Bottom of the third inning, 2-0 Kansas City. Jackie Bradley Jr. will lead off. Brock Holt and Xander Bogaerts to follow. Jackie comes to the plate, hitting 272, 21 homers, 73 runs batted in. Facing Yordano Ventura. Ventura 2-2 versus the Red Sox, making his fifth career start against Boston. His ERA against the Red Sox is 5.48. So the pitch coming to Jackie, left-hander. Left-handed batter, anyway, standing in the box, waiting. Now, finally, Ventura goes into the wind of the pitch. Swung on and roped to right. Over the leaping Hosmer down the right field line, a base hit. Big turnaround first for Jackie. He's got a first pitch leadoff single to start the bottom of the third inning.
So five of the nine batters, first time around have reached base.
Well, now it's time to do something with them. Royals middle infield will shift to double play depth. Third baseman Cuthbert will come in on the grass at third base for the left-handed hitting Holt, who is 1-for-1. Brock singled to center field in the first inning. Cuthbert already charging, and Holt looks at a pitch on the outside corner. They don't see the Red Sox sacrifice much.
We did see the sacrifice pay off for Kansas City in the second inning. This time Cuthbert backs up even with the bag as the pitch goes way outside, reaching far to his left as Perez making the grab of a 99-mile-an-hour fastball that almost got by him. One ball and one strike. Holt hitting 256 after his single in the first. Jackie lead at first base, held on by Hosmer. The pitch swung on and a ground ball to short. Flipped to second for Juan Mondesi's turn. That's a double play. Three double plays in three innings for the Kansas City Royals. This is prime example of why the double play is the pitcher's best friend. Leadoff single in the first, then an inning-ending double play hit into by Ortiz. Leadoff single in the second. Ramirez hits into a double play, erasing Betts, and now a leadoff single by Bradley. And Holt hits into a 6-4-3 double play. Two outs, bases empty for Xander Bogaerts. Boy, three straight innings, three leadoff hits, and three double plays. I don't think we've seen that all season, Joe. This is game number 130.
That's actually in the middle of the pack and grounding at a double plays in the league.
Xander takes a strike and it's 1-1.
It only seems like they've hit into more than anybody else. It's 112.
Ready for the 1-1 pitch is Bogaerts. And he waves and misses at a curveball. Ball at two strikes. Big gap in left center. That's how teams have been playing Xander in recent days. Tampa played him the same way. Right fielder shifted a little bit toward right center. Looks at a pitch outside. Checked his swing. They appeal to first base umpire Eric Cooper, who agrees. So it's a two-ball, two-strike count to Bogaerts. Ventura off the back of the mound, rubbing up the baseball as Xander kicks some dirt around on the right-hand batter's box. Bases empty, two outs, two balls and two strikes the count. Ventura, long look in at Perez. Now he's got the sign, turns and fires home, and it's outside and low, 3-2. Full count to Bogaerts. Trying to come in with a changeup that time. His changeup is hard to differentiate from a lot of guys' fastballs. 90 miles an hour on the change again. Payoff pitch. Xander bounces it foul. This broadcast authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the Red Sox to WEEI strictly for the entertainment of our listening audience. Any broadcast, rebroadcast, or other use of the accounts and descriptions of this game without the express written consent of WEEI and the Boston Red Sox is strictly prohibited. 3-2 pitch again from Ventura to Bogaerts. Swung on and missed. Strike three. Xander goes down on strikes. The third double play in as many innings hurts the Red Sox as we go. 2-0 Kansas City, top of the fourth inning. Erod set to face Alex Gordon. Let's pause 10 seconds for our stations to identify themselves on the Shaw's WEEI Red Sox Radio Network.
The radio home for Boston Red Sox baseball. This is Sports Radio WEEI Boston. WEEI-FM and HD1 Lawrence, Boston.
Alex Gordon tonight 1-for-1 with a run scored. He singled after the Perez home run in the second inning. Red Sox are shifted to the right form. First ball swinging. Ground ball slowly hit to Ramirez. He grabs it, drops it, now tosses it to Erod, who beats Gordon to the bag. A little shaky at first base tonight so far for Hanley Ramirez, but they get the out anyway, and there's one down quickly in the fourth. And now with an Xfinity X1 scoreboard update, here's Christian Arcan.
Thank you, Tim. The scoreboard update is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. The Red Sox have hit into three double plays tonight, but they have some work to do to catch the Marlins. The Fish hitting into six twin killings today in a 3-1 loss to the Padres in Miami. The six double plays, a one-game Marlin franchise record.
And not very good.
No.
Not one that they're happy about.
A little dubious.
That's for sure. Now, Alcides Escobar, the shortstop, who's been in the middle of the three double plays here tonight, is at the plate with one out, bases empty, taking all the way. He takes a strike.
Over in Detroit, the Angels blanked the Tigers 5-0. Jeffrey Marte doing work against his former team. He had three runs batted in. Tyler Skaggs, the win, allowed just two hits in six shutout innings.
Low ball, one strike pitch. Popped up. Shallow right field. Drifting out is Brock Holt. The second baseman makes the catch. Two quick outs.
And the Blue Jays and Orioles both winners today. The Jays coming back to beat the Twins 9-6. The Orioles blanking the Yankees 5-0. Want an easy way to see if you could save money on car insurance? Geico gives you three. Call 1-800-947-AUTO. Go online to geico.com or stop by the Geico office near you. Three ways you could save 15% or more. Tim?
Thanks, Christian. Raul Mondesi at the plate now. He laid down a very good sacrifice bunt in the second inning. Almost turned it into a hit. They're very quick to get down the first baseline. A switch hitter batting right-handed. Takes ball one. A fastball from Rodriguez, 96. His dad was National League Rookie of the Year with the Dodgers. And a strike called. One ball and one strike. That was at a time when, probably toward the end of the time when the Dodgers were running off a string of National League Rookies of the Year. 1-1 pitch. That's outside. Two balls and a strike. But what we've seen out of Mondesi so far, the rookie, even though his batting average hasn't been stellar, it's 184. But he does possess some good skills that the Royals are hoping to develop as he fouls this pitch back. I think defensively, the play that he made in the first inning on an absolute missile hit at him by David Ortiz and started that inning-ending double play. That was exceptional. Mondesi waits, and the 2-2 pitch is low. His dad played 13 seasons in the majors and winning the NL Rookie of the Year in 1994 with Los Angeles. Played for the Dodgers 1993 to 1999. There's a ground ball hit towards short. A few steps towards second as Bogaerts on the run makes the throw. And he's got Mondesi. And that's the first clean inning for Erod tonight as the Royals go down in order. 1-2. Now back to business. And the first pitch is in for a strike. Nothing and one to David. 319 is average after his at-bat in the first. He's been hitting 320 tonight. And his number is off the charts good. The pitch outside and low. Talking about 30 home runs, 40 doubles. 41 now and 100 RBIs. Three infielders to the right. The pitch, that's in the dirt. Two balls and a strike. We've talked about it a number of times. As far as the doubles are concerned, if David could run, his legs are really just hanging on now in his final season. But if he could run, he might have about 55 doubles. He swings and drives one deep to right center field toward the triangle. This ball's back and this ball is gone. A home run just behind the Red Sox bullpen over the triangle into the center field seats. Ortiz makes it 2-1. Home run number 31 for Big Poppy. And he is now tied with Jimmy Fox for 18th all-time on the home run list with 534 career home runs. A line shot to center that just got out.
What a rocket. David did not know it was gone. Question was, would it be high enough? And he was running hard.
Left the bat at 108 miles an hour. Estimated distance 413 feet. And that cuts the lead. It's now 2-1. And here is Mookie Betts.
It's a way to stay out of double plays. Hit the ball out of the park.
That's a great way. That's the best way. And Mookie fouls this one back. Count is even, 1-1. Mookie with a second best average against right-handed pitching in the American League. 331. One ball, one strike pitch. And he swings and fouls it back into the glove of Perez, the catcher.
Gives Poppy 60 RBIs on Sunday night baseball, more than anybody. since they started broadcasting Sunday nights on ESPN 1990s. 21 home runs, second.
1-2 foul tipped, and that caught Parter Perez. He has to take the mask off. He's doubled over.
That's one behind Alex Rodriguez, who had 22, and one ahead of Pujols, who has 20.
That's a lot of home runs in prime time. Goes back to a statement he made in spring training that I like, and it had something to do not with the prime time context, but more so about when the regular season started, he'd be ready. He said, when the light goes on, Big Poppy goes on. And I think that does relate to his prime time performances. Well, Salvi Perez got a foul ball that came up behind home plate, behind the point of home plate, and went up and got him around the neck and underneath his chin. That's in a tough spot. He's being looked at right now by one of the Kansas City trainers. And even though you have the throat protector, remember they used to have the old plastic flaps that would go way down. Now they've been replaced by steel bars. But that one came up at such a straight angle and got him right under the chin near the neck. It's got to be pretty painful. So they'll continue to look at Perez, but David Ortiz with a leadoff home run. RBI number 101. It was his 2,441st hit. And he's tied with Jimmy Fox for 18th all-time, 534 homers. He has two more to catch Mickey Mantle. Mantle with 536. And David could do that by the time this homestand is over. And after Mantle, it's Mike Schmidt. But he's got a way to go to catch Mike Schmidt. Schmidt, 16th all-time with 548 home runs. Perez is up and ready to go again. He'll get set to crouch down behind home plate. Don't forget to stay tuned for the Sunoco postgame show. The Sunoco Free Fuel 5000. Get the decal, get spotted, win. Well, Perez will take a couple of warm-up pitches from Venturi. Seems to be okay. Mookie behind in the count, 1-2. Ventura looking in for a sign. He's got it. Now he goes into his wind and the 1-2 pitch. And Mookie pops it up. Shallow right. Out goes Mondesi, the second baseman. In comes Lorenzo Cain. He'll make the catch. And there's one out. Drake's Cakes would like to remind you to take a Drake's break and enjoy one of your favorite Drake's Cakes. This baseball season, Yankee Doodles from Drake's are back as Yankee Doodles Iced Cupcakes. They've got the same great taste with a fun new look. So listen to your craving and grab some today. Hanley Ramirez grounded into a double play in the second inning. Hanley homered last night as part of back-to-back homers with Mookie Betts in the fifth inning. He swings and fouls one off to the right into the State Street Pavilion. 98-mile-an-hour fastball from Ventura. No balls and one strike to Hanley Ramirez. Well, Hanley taking his time, getting back in the batter's box, now finally set. And making Ventura wait, who's been patiently standing on top of the hill. Hanley goes through his routine. And now Ventura is set to pitch. Outside target by Perez. The pitch missed the target. A line shot right at Cain. Almost took his glove off in right field. Cain started in a few steps. And Hanley staring at him out there. They're communicating from long distance right now. But, boy, that was a bullet hit to right field. And Cain might have misjudged that a little bit off the bat. Didn't really need to come in. He did so. And that ball almost took his glove off. There are two men out now for the Red Sox in the fourth inning. Hard line drive out. Batter is Travis Shaw. The left-handed hitter takes a strike low. And a David Ortiz home run left the yard at 108 miles an hour. Hanley's was 109 miles an hour into the glove of Lorenzo Cain. Shaw takes low. One ball, one strike.
Sure is not missing many bats, but those double plays have been huge.
Oh, they've been saving him at this point in time. They have been huge for the Royals. And the 1-1. And Shaw lines it down the left field side. That's just foul. Sliced into the seats. That was down the line. Looked like it went on the first or second row where the seats angle out and go parallel to the foul line. Not a lot of room down there in fair territory, or foul territory, I should say, that would be in play. 1-2. Pitch up high. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Wednesday, August 31st is Lego Day at Fenway Park. With the purchase of a game ticket through this special offer, fans receive a limited edition Red Sox-themed player build made with Lego bricks. Pitch to Shaw is in the dirt. As well as access to the pregame Lego build experience in the Kids Concourse. A life-size player Lego model will also be unveiled during the experience. Tickets are limited, so go to RedSox.com/Lego to get yours today. That'll be a fun night for the kids, and I'll bet there are some adults who will like the Legos as well. Some young adults probably still like them. Ready for the payoff. Here's the pitch. And Shaw lifts one high in the air to right center. Drifting over is Kane, the right fielder. The center fielder, Orlando, will call him off. And just in front of the triangle, he'll make the catch for out number 3. Red Sox get on the board as David Ortiz hits career home run number 534.
Top of the order here is Paulo Orlando. Drove in the runs, the difference in the game, with a sac fly in the second. He grounded a short to open the game, and he takes a call strike. 3 of his last 36. Orlando from Brazil, a longtime minor leaguer. Pitches up and in off the mid of the catcher, goes to the backstop. The road ahead brought to you by the Maine Office of Tourism. Discovering your Maine thing begins at visitmaine.com. Red Sox head to San Francisco. They play the Oakland A's starting Friday night, then San Diego, then Toronto. Explore the West Quoddy Head Lighthouse or visit 2 dozen other lighthouses open statewide September 10th. There's a little pop on the infield. Holt broke back, now comes in, makes the catch on the dirt for the out. September 10th is Maine Open Lighthouse Day. Learn more, visit Maine.com. Here's Cuthbert now. Had an infield hit in the first and struck out his next time up. And we'll have a delay here with a fan on the field. That'll take care of him. Spent a night in jail.
Never worth it. Never worth it. It's...
So silly.
One of the dumbest things you could do at a sporting event. He's a young guy and he's about to learn a hard lesson. That is just stupid.
So he delays the game for 38,000 plus here in a national TV audience and a national radio audience too. Red Sox Baseball brought to you by OD Household Services, self-moving services that deliver. Get a quote at odmove.com for your next move. One out, base is empty. Rod seems to have settled down a little bit. There's not a lot of hit since the Alex Gordon single in the second. Had a granted time, he fired it in anyway. All right, here's the pitch. Outside for a ball. Here comes the 1-0. And a swinging strike and an off-speed pitch down and away. One of the better changeups that Erod has thrown. That was 89 on the radar gun. Two to one Royals in the fifth. The pitch. There's a shot hit softly to second. Grabbed nicely by Holt. He didn't move an inch. Right at him chest high. A little flare. He's positioned perfectly. And they're two men down. And here's Lorenzo Cain. Right fielder with a fly ball to right and a 5-3 ground out. Tampa Bay coming tomorrow. Manny Andrees, who had 8 strikeouts against the Red Sox last Thursday, goes against Rick Porcello, 17-3. Fastball in for a strike, and of course, we'll have plenty of guests during the game tomorrow, and we'll be updating you on the Arbella Tote Board as to our Jimmy Fund radio telephone totals. Ground ball hit weakly to the charging shortstop. Bogarts has the bare hand, throws again, and gets him. Second time he's done that tonight. That looked like an instant replay. David Ortiz hitting number 534 tonight. Tied with Jimmy Fox. The pitch inside. Mickey Mantle's next. 536. Mick hit number 535 on a pitch that was grooved by Denny McClain. The 1-0. Low and away. Jim Price, the Tiger broadcaster, tells us the story. Often he was catching. Told Mantle the room service fastball was coming right down the middle. And Mickey didn't believe him. Took the pitch for a strike. 2-0 is low and inside. McClain then made a gesture indicating another one was coming, and Price let him know it. And Mickey hit the next pitch in the upper deck for 535. 3-0 is in there for a strike. That was the year McClain won 31. 1968. 3-1. Ground ball bounced to deep third, and it's off the glove of the third baseman rolling over by the ball attendant. That'll be a hit for Young. So he's 2-for-2. That Cuthbert stabbed it, he would have had a long throw from foul ground, but he couldn't come up with it. So it's a hit, and here comes Sandy Leon, who's now 0 for his last 12 after a fly ball to left his first time up.
Cuthbert had that ball lined up, but not well enough as he turned to make the backhand. It hit the last finger on his glove. It hit the side of it, glanced off of it. Misjudged that last bounce.
So the tying run is on. Ventura delivers the pitch, is outside. Tough to play hit and run with this guy. He throws so hard and he can be wild. You have to think about it, though, with all the double plays.
Yeah, I think the Red Sox are going to try to start a runner when they get an opportunity.
1-0 pitch. Up and away, 2-0. So Ventura has walked one. He's only fan one, despite his 97 and 98 mile an hour fastball. That last one was 99. Now Rue Mondesi visits the mound. The 21-year-old. Two balls, no strikes to Sandy. JBJ on deck. Here's the 2-0. And he takes outside. This with another 99 mile an hour pitch. Should be taking here. Donald Ventura delivers, and he drops a strike in there over the inner half. It starts with half a dozen hits, but they trail 2-1. Here comes a 3-1. Sandy tops a roller foul by the Red Sox dugout. So the count has gone full. We'll see what Young does here. He's had a look at Brian Butterfield in the third base coaching box. Royals 2, Red Sox 1. Lead off man on, nobody out here in the fifth. Ventura to the set. The runner holds the pitch, swinging the drive to center field, hit deep. Back goes the center fielder. Orlando reaches. No, he missed it. He missed it. Off his glove. Sandy on his way to second. And Young to third by the Royals, who have a great defensive outfield, normally make plays like that. Orlando was there right in front of the bleacher bar. And he reached up, and a ball ticked off his glove. Would not have been a really difficult catch. He did have to go a distance. So it's two bases for Sandy. We'll see how they score it. So the tying runs at third. Go-ahead run at second. And here's Jackie, who singled a right his first time up.
It looks like he short-armed that a little bit, Joe. I think they're going to give him an error.
Here's the pitch. And it bounces in. Nice save by Salvi Perez. And we haven't seen the scoring yet. That's an error. Two base error. Rare error for Royals outfielder. One and nothing. And Chira ready, the pitch. And that dips low. This with a curve. He's up to 75 pitches, only 41 strikes. A-Rod settled down some, but Ventura's been struggling. Might be out of the game without those double plays. Long look in, shakes a sign. Jackie granted time. Jackie hitting ninth. If I want to keep some of the pressure off, so he's kept him in the ninth spot. The pitch. Way outside. Walk could load him up for Brock Holt. Here comes a 3-0 pitch. Way outside and high. They're loaded up. That's how you do for a bases loaded hit.
Yeah, they have really struggled as a team in these situations. Again, bases loaded, nobody out. A chance not only to tie the game, but to take the lead.
Hitting .212 as a team with the bases loaded. 3 for 24, 4 grand slams. And it's Brock Holt, who blooped a single to center and grounded into a 6-4-3 double play. Brock is 1 for 5 with the sacks full. Stirring in the Royals bullpen. See if anybody gets up to throw. Chris Young at third. Sandy Leon at second. Jackie Bradley Jr. at first with nobody out. Brock Holt in the leadoff spot. A chance to do some damage here. They're in at first and third. Double play depth at second and short. All right. Ventura ready. The pitch to Brock. Outside, ball one. He's missed with five in a row.
You got to make him give you a strike here.
He should be on the pitcher with the bases loaded. Ventura setting. His 1-0 pitch. And a strike. Got a fastball in there at 98. Pretty much down the middle. Now they get a left-hander up in their pen. Brian Flynn. One and one. And the pitch. Oh, he chased the slider in the dirt. One and two. It's not Flynn, it's Matt Strom, who's done very well for them. Matt Strom, a lefty warming. 80 pitches now, only 43 strikes for Ventura, but he's had a hold one and two. He's thinking strikeout here with Xander to follow. The 1-2 pitch. Swing, a bounding ball hit weakly to first. Hosmer has it, concedes the run, goes to the bag for the out at two softly. Game is tied at two. Holt gets a run home, out three unassisted. His 30th RBI as Chris Young scores the tying run.
Yeah, Young read it right off the bat quickly. He realized that he had the break on contact. Obviously, with the bases loaded, ball hit on the ground, he's going to do that. But he got a good jump. And when Hosmer finally grabbed the baseball in the slow roller, he realized that Young was practically home.
had no play there to get the force at the plate.
So we're tied second and third, one out for Xander. Allowed a bullet to right and then struck out swinging on a changeup. Orlando's ready to catch a line drive, pivotal. And the low and away, ball one with a curve. So Sandy the runner at third and Jackie at second. Poppy on deck, so they're going to try to attack Bogarts here. And the 1-0. Ground ball up the middle, and it's through for a base hit. Here comes Sandy. Right behind him, Jackie Bradley Jr. A two-run single for Xander Bogarts, and the Red Sox lead it 4-2. Xander bouncing a 1-0 pitch just to the left of second base. Escobar had no chance. He hit it hard. And RBIs number 75 and 76 for Xander. 4-2 Red Sox. They leave for the first time tonight. And here comes Ned Yost. That's going to do it. Strom hasn't had a lot of time to warm. And now he makes the move for the lefty. So 4-2 Red Sox. They've scored three. And the air is certainly looming very large. Our call to the bullpen coming your way on the Shaw's WEEI Red Sox Radio Network. His first big league win over the Tigers recently. David, who hit number 534 last time up, takes outside, ball one at 96. He bounced into a 4-6-3 double play, a wicked shot hit to the second baseman that almost knocked him down, but they turned two and then opened the fourth by hitting a 2-1 pitch into the bleachers. The pitch foul to the backstop on a high fastball. Strom is the only active player born in North Dakota. There's other notables. Darren Erstad of the Angels, Travis Hafner of Cleveland in Texas, Tim Johnson, Rick Helling. Throw to first, runner back standing safely. That's home of the guy that plays Bill Lee in the movie, our friend Josh DeMille. He's from North Dakota. 1-1. Foul to the left, out of play. Into the State Street Pavilion. Strom is 24, 6'3", 200. Four runs, seven hits for the Red Sox. Two runs, three hits for the Royals. Still only one out. Three runs home. And the 1-2. Swing a hard shot to second. Should be two. Mondesi to Escobar on to first. And David grounds into his 22nd double play of the year to retire the side after 5-4-2 Red Sox on the Shaw's WEE. Going four runs, three earned on seven hits. He walked two, one hurt. Fan only one. Right, here's Eric Hosmer. Walked and grounded out to the pitcher. And he takes a fastball too tight, ball one. Sixth inning, and the Red Sox with a 4-2 lead. There's a foul to the left out of play.
Well, Hosmer doesn't get cheated very much in his swings, does he?
He really takes a big rip. He's got a very pronounced triggering motion. The 1-1, and he grounds a foul off his leg. Red Sox record for grinding in a double play, 6-1 game. That's what the Marlins did today against San Diego. That ties the major league record. They did it in 66 against the Angels and 86 against Chicago. A game I remember well, 1990, July 18th against Minnesota. Inside, not only did they ground into six double plays in that 1990 game against the Twins, but they grounded into two triple plays. And they won the game 1-0. Tim Nehring got his first Major League RBI to win it. 2-2, poke foul to the left out of play. It was unbelievable. That was under Joe Morgan. Six grounded into double plays and two grounded into triple plays. Both were started by Gary Gaetti at third base.
There's no way you should win a game when that happens.
It was incredible. 2-2 pitch. Foul to the backstop. They've grounded into four tonight, but have a 4-2 lead. Remember the Sunoco postgame show, the Sunoco Free Fuel 5000. Get the decal, get spotted, win. Two and two to Eric Hosmer. And the pitch on its way in tight. He almost jumped into that one. He rides 79 pitches, 45 strike, 57% after a very slow start throwing strikes. The payoff pitch coming to the left-hand hitter, and he takes inside ball four. It brings the tying run to the plate. Certainly, Erod wanted to avoid a walk, his third. And here's Morales, who fly to right and hit one off the body of Erod. He picked it up and had time to get the runner, but threw it in the dirt, was charged with an error. He's at 80 pitches. It really nothing more than the normal limit. As he comes off the hamstring issue, call strike. Morales extremely slow, so he can be doubled. Here's the 0-1 outside. This is the guy that hit a walk-off grand slam for the Angels and jumped on home plate, was pounded on by his teammates and suffered a broken leg and missed more than a year. So the Angels at the time. 1-1, way outside. Royals last in the league in runs scored. But they have been hot. Won 11 of their last 13. Two-one pitch. D-Rod deals. And that's low. And now the Red Sox bullpen springs into action.
Before the walk to Hosmer, and still with the walk to Hosmer, after the sacrifice fly by Orlando in the second inning, the Royals are 0-for-11.
Matt Barnes getting loose. 3-1 is driven to right field. This is trouble down the line. It hits on the track. Takes one hop into the seats for a ground rule double. That puts runners at second and third with nobody out. So now they can tie with a base hit. And they've got one of their best up in Salvi Perez, the catcher, who homered off the pole and left. High towering shot in the second inning. His 20th of the year. Then at a fly ball to left. It's a bad pitch, a high fastball away. And Morales drove it hard down the right field line. Bounced about 10 feet past the pole into the seats. So A-Rod, given the lead, is struggling. The first hit since Gordon singled in the second. But the leadoff walk really hurt. Barnes heating hurriedly. Four hits for the Royals, and again, only 55% strikes for Eduardo Rodriguez. Infield back, they'll concede a run for an out. The pitch to Salvi Perez is popped up right side near the stands, and it's going to be out of play. Hanley stood up on the tarp, but it was two rows back. Nothing in one. Erod set to deal. He fires. And a foul again to the right out of play. So nothing in two. Perez does not strike out all that much for a power hitter. Well, he's up to 101, so he struck out more this year. He's only walked 16 times. The 0-2. Swing and a pop-up foul behind the plate. This is out of play. Tim's got the glove ready.
Yep, should have had it down here last night. But nothing gets by me tonight. Up here in the booth.
You almost got nailed twice, huh?
It passed me to my left, hit the door, came right back to my right by my ear and out the window. Had my reading glasses on. I couldn't really see it well.
Here's the 0-2. It bounced in, knocked down by Sandy. Yeah, if you were on the field, you wouldn't be wearing your reading glasses.
No, I would not be. No.
So, got a job to do first. That makes it doubly tough to make the play.
Well, I think if I had my glove, I would have made it, but I left it in my locker. But I got it tonight, just in case.
And that one, a check swing, it's in the dirt. So it's 2-2. This is a critical batter here for Erod. Chad Alex Gordon on deck. Left-hand batter, but he has a solid hit last in the second inning. Erod sets. The 2-2. Low and inside. Well, he was 0-2. Well, I could load him up and could bring Matt Barnes out, even though a lefty's next. And Leon goes out to visit with Eduardo.
And that'll give Barnes a chance to throw a couple more pitches. But Barnes looks like he's ready. He's slowed down. He's standing on the mound out there.
Now his team just gave him the lead for the first time. And Erod certainly could have used a shutdown inning. He could still do it, but it would take some doing. Ready for a 3-2. Here it is. And a ground ball top foul to the on-deck area where Alex Gordon is standing. It was his 92nd pitch with nobody out here in the sixth. But he's not had great command, and now Hanley visits the mound, and so does Sandy Leon.
And following him right from home plate is the home plate umpire, Chad Whitson, because Sandy just made a visit. So Chad's saying, hey, didn't you guys have a conversation already?
Barnes is ready. I mean, what that was all about. Might have been signaled from the dugout. Eduardo with a 3-2 pitch to Salvi Perez. Here it is. Inside, he walked him. Missed with a fastball. And this guy's, we said, tough to walk. The 17th walk of the year. The bases are loaded. Carl Willis is going to come out, so that means they're going to leave him in to face the lefty. Even though he's walked the lefty, giving up a double to a right-hand hitter and walked a right-hand hitter. We take a 10-second break on the Shaw's WEEI Red Sox Radio Network.
Talk Sox and more on the Drive Home with Dale and Holly weekdays 2 to 6 on Sports Radio WEEI Boston. WEEI FM and HD1 Lawrence, Boston.
Long talk by Carl Willis. We don't have that 30-second clock anymore, huh? Did that go away on its own?
I'm looking at it. There's no numbers on it. I don't know. Maybe they quietly turned it off. Didn't tell anybody.
There was no pronouncement that we know of.
No. I think most around the game realize it's kind of a silly rule.
All right. Three on. Nobody out. Gordon with a hard single to right and a 3-1 ground out. Erod on the ropes. Bases loaded. 4-2 Red Sox in the sixth. Here's the pitch of the left-hand batter, and Gordon fouls it back and out of play. He is hitting only 228 after he had a big free agent contract. He really has been the face of their franchise. Number one pick out of Nebraska. Second overall his year. And an all-star. Signed as a third baseman. Came up as a third baseman. He's become a gold glove outfielder. A platinum glove outfielder, too. The 0-1. Inside. Shaw playing halfway to second on the left side. Bogarts and Holt in double play depth. And they were out of the line at first with the bases all occupied. 1-1 to Alex Gordon. Here's the pitch. Inside. 2-1. Still nobody out. Gordon in his 10th year. He's 32. Three-time All-Star. Four gold gloves in the outfield. Two and one the count. Erod is ready. He fires. Inside, ball three. He's missing inside with his fastball to left-hand hitters. As he did a walk Hosmer to open the inning. So he's one pitch away from a shower. Three and one to Alex Gordon. Eduardo Rodriguez delivers. Swinging a fly ball left field, not too deep. Young makes the catch. The runner tags and holds. Well, Eric Hosmer and a ball hit to medium depth left. Of course, it's short here with the wall so close. Tagged and did not score. And that's going to do it for Erod. He gets a big out. Matt Barnes coming on to face Escobar. And Art called to the bullpen with the Red Sox still leading at 4-2. Coming your way of the Shaw's WEEI Red Sox Radio Network.
The Ford Freedom Sales Event.
Opponent's hitting 235 against him, but he has given up six home runs, a walk 26 in 58 and two-thirds innings, while fanning 62. So it's been up and down, but chance here to keep the lead here for the Red Sox as Matt will face Escobar. And after that, as we say, Mondesi, who's a switch hitter, but hitting under 200. Let's see, Matt has inherited 37 runners and six have scored. So he's prevented 31. That's not bad. He's had three games of the bases loaded this year. And none of those inherited runners has scored. So he'd like to duplicate that again. Key spot in this game. Hosmer at third. Morales at second. Perez at first. One out. Barnes facing Escobar. Contact hitter. And the pitch. And he takes a curve low. Started him out with a breaking ball. It was a labor for Erod. He fanned only one. Only out four hits, but walked four. And time granted as Escobar backs out. In field of double play depth, Escobar does have pretty good running speed. The runner at second, very slow, Morales. Slow runner at first, and Perez. Here's the 1-0. And he chops one off the plate. It's grabbed by Barnes and has to go to first. Too late. Baltimore chopper. Run scores and it's 4-3.
That ball had helium in it. It just stayed up in the air.
Matt 6-5, but didn't know much about it.
Everybody just ran under the hang time.
Bounced it right off home plate to the left side of the mound and in on the grass. Oh, that was high. Probably 20 feet high. There was no chance for Hosmer at home, and the throw at first was not all that close. So the Red Sox with just a one-run lead. Infield hit, Escobar's 39th RBI. And with the bases loaded, here's Mondesi, who sacrificed and grounded out to the shortstop. tough man to double with his speed. And Barnes, granted, time backs off. Boy, made a pretty good pitch, but he chopped it right off home plate. It bounced so high. Morales, the tying run at third. Perez at second, the pitch. And a drive hit deep to right center into the triangle. Way back it goes, and it hits in the triangle, rattles around. Two runs have scored. Here comes Escobar with a third run. It's a triple for Mondesi, and Kansas City has the lead 6-4. That's a home run in just about any other ballpark. Hit the side wall into the triangle, not far from where the pitcher stands, and rattles around. He hit that ball about 410 feet in the air. Raul Mondesi, a 184 hitter, entering the game with a three-run triple. So two of those runs charged to Erod. He's on the hook right now. And the last one charged to Barnes. But that ball was crushed. Barnes has had trouble with a long ball. And here's Orlando. And he takes inside ball one. He's grounded a short. With a sack fly to deep center and popped to second. So here I charge with five runs on four hits, four walks, and a strikeout, and five and a third. It was shaky performance, especially with his control issues. Barnes has given up hits to the first two men. One soft, one crushed, the pitch. Strike over the inside edge with the infield in. Now the Royals have put a four spot on the board, still only one out. The both starters very shaky tonight. Barnes with a 1-1. Taken high, so he had allowed just six runners, inherited runners, to score this year, and he gives up three here in the sixth inning. Mike Mondesi really gave that ball a ride. 2-1 pitch to Orlando. And he fouls one off his leg in the batter's box.
He ran right out of the batter's box. He didn't take anything for granted. In fact, he had to be held up coming around third. He was thinking four bases.
Well, he can really motor. Bobby Ross Jr. warming. Two and two. Big run at third here, the pitch. And it hits him. Oh, it hit him on the hand. Question was, did it hit him or the bat? But it sounded like it hit him, and that's what the umpire, Chad Whitson, called. So Barnes still hasn't retired a batter. Infield hit, a long triple, and now a hit batsman. And Cuthbert coming up. Set an infield hit, struck out, and lined softly to second. Now this inning has become a disaster.
Red Sox getting some help up in the bullpen. Robbie Ross Jr. now beginning to throw. Of course, things have not gone well for either Erod or Matt Barnes.
The walk to Perez really hurt Erod. He was ahead 0-2. All right, right-hand batter up, so there is a double play situation in order. And the pitch is in there for a strike to the rookie. The Red Sox lose, they'd be two behind Toronto and just one ahead of Baltimore. Oh, and one. Barnes deals, and a weak chopper hit out front. Here comes another run. The throw to the plate, safe. Barnes grabbed it, barehanded it, flipped to Sandy. He went down to the ground and he beat it. Mondesi can motor. He was off on contact, and it's 7-4. Still only one out. That'll be, well, we'll see if they scored a fielder's choice or an infield hit. Barnes grabbed it nicely with a bare hand, but Sandy out in front of the plate tried to reach back and tag Mondesi. and he couldn't do it. And John Farrell wants this look that I think he's coming out to talk to Eric Cooper. And they will look. They will look. Well, this is a big run here. Zanny went reaching. I don't think they're going to win this one.
Now, Mondesi's foot came over the plate, but it looked like he touched it on the backside of home plate. The question was, where did Sandy tag him? But this play doesn't even look close. I don't even know if Sandy tagged him at all. And Sandy had a sweep tag, but Mondesi's momentum kept him going away from the glove of the catcher.
But such a big run here, you might as well look, but I don't think they have much of a shot to have this one overturned.
Yeah, I'm really not sure why they challenge it, other than it's a big run, but the play's not really close.
The two choppers of the pitcher really hurt. Sandwiched around a booming triple and a hit batsman. They really haven't scored it yet, have they? Fielder's choice, or can't they wait to see?
Wait to see how they ultimately call it, but with right Barnes now, coming home, you'd think it'd be a fielder's choice.
Now they have called it a fielder's choice. So it'll be a time at bat, and let's see if now the headsets come off. And the ruling is safe. But I suppose the way this inning has gone, it was worth the gamble. But not much of a shot to overturn it. Cuthbert getting his 41st RBI. Mondesi scoring on the fielder's choice. He can really motor.
Well, if he can get his batting average in a reasonable area, I think he's going to turn out to be a very good player. Well,
he's only 21. And good bloodlines, the son of Raul Mondesi, the great Dodger star. Number 9 hitter with a booming triple off Barnes, who's yet to retire a batter. Matt's been charged with two runs himself already and allowed three inherited runners to score. First and second for the ninth man to bat this inning, Lorenzo Cain, who's 0 for 3. Barnes deals and bounces a breaking ball. Nice. Ross getting ready for Hosmer.
You look at a three-run lead, Joe, as you start to think about getting into the later stages in this game. The starter, Ventura, is out. And this Kansas City bullpen has been unbelievable this season.
Even without their best, Wade Davis, who's still on an injury rehab in the minors, due back around September 1st. The 1-0 riding up and away. Now, this one, of course, is not just the bullpen. A-Rod did not pitch well. Four walks and five and a third. And two of them scored. 2-0 pitch. Cain takes a strike. Brett Sachs got one in the fourth to cut the lead to 2-1. Three in the fifth to take a 4-2 lead. But Kansas City's got a five spot on the board now. Still only one man out here in the sixth. They had only six hits, but those walks and hit batsmen have hurt. The 2-1 pitch to Cain. And that rides high. It's very likely to be the last batter for Barnes. Having a rough outing. Three-one pitch. And he swings and rips one to left. This is trouble. It hits off the base of the wall. Another run is scored. And stopping at second is Cuthbert. It's 8-4 Kansas City. Six runs home here, and that's going to do it for Barnes, who does not retire a batter. The ball hit the bottom of the AL East standings. Tear him quickly to Young, but the runner saw he had no chance to catch it. So Orlando scored easily from second base. Cuthbert stopped at second. Kane with his 54th RBI. And Matt Barnes in charge with three runs, responsible for two men on. He did not record an out. So here's Robbie Ross as batter. He did not face Hosmer last night. Here's the pitch, and it's low and away. Cuthbert at second base, and Lorenzo Cain at first. Means RBI is 54th. The pitch, breaking ball in for a strike. Right now, Strom, the pitcher record on the plus side. He got a double play from Ortiz. He's been sitting a long time. But he'll be coming out from the bottom of the sixth because nobody's warming. The 1-1, foul to the left of the screen, out of play. This is the 10th man to bat here in the Royal sixth. Very painful top of the sixth for the Red Sox. 1-2 to Hosmer, the pitch. And he swings and drives one to left. This is trouble. Young looking up. It's off the Foxwood sign. He grabs the carom on the fly. Another run is scored. Now Kane runs through a stop sign. He's coming home. And he slides in safely. Two run score and a wall ball single by Eric Hosmer. And it's 10-4 Kansas City. It's been an 8-run inning. Young did all he could. The ball hit the Foxwood sign above the American League scores. He grabbed the carom before it hit the ground. But Kane, running hard, came home. He read it pretty well. And here is Morales, who doubled earlier this inning. Still only one man out. So Barnes gives up five runs, charged with these two. Five runs, three hits, a hit batsman without retiring a batter. Going inside, ball one, that does big damage to his ERA. And Ross allows two inherited runners to score. He came with some daring base running, made it. Wasn't all that close, the 1-0. Swinging strike.
Joe, this is the worst single inning of the season. You go back to the next closest one, July 2nd, the seventh inning against the Angels when they put seven runs up. Wow. Put more than that, actually. No, it's the second worst.
There's a line drive, and that's a base hit in the left field over Bogart's glove. Morales' second hit of the inning. Stopping at second is Hosmer after his wall ball single. Erod's ERA went up to 5.35 from 5.11. Barnes up to 4.45 from 3.68. Well, that was another rocket off Robbie Ross.
Well, I take that back. I want to make a correction. That was a 10-run inning in the seventh on July 2nd, so it's the second worst.
That was the 21-2.
Right.
Ball one to Salvi Perez. Still only one out.
Yeah, this is incredible. I mean, they just take the lead, too, at 4-2. And then everything just falls apart in the sixth inning. And then some.
The starter and the bullpen responsible. Perez with a home run, a fly to left that he walked this inning. Call strike. He was behind 0-2, fouled off a couple of pitches, and then worked a walk, which is very tough to do. He's walked only 17 times all year. And that's how wild Erod was. Two on, still one out. The pitch, ground ball chop weakly to third, charge and glove by Shaw, throws on the move and got him. Fortunately, had a slow-footed catcher. Well, Ross finally gets an out, and here's Gordon. Came up with the bases loaded, made the first out, a fly ball to the left, not deep enough to score a run. He's 1-for-3. 10-4 Kansas City. See, Ross has now inherited 31 runners, 9 have scored. And his lead at second and third, Hosmer at third. And Morales at second, and that one misses for a ball. This is the 13th man to bat in the top of the sixth. 8 runs, 6 hits, 2 walks, the hit batsman, a fielder's choice. Red Sox pitchers have thrown 52 pitches in this frame. All right, the pitch to Gordon's right over the middle to call strike. A-Rod, the pitcher of record. You give up 5. Barnes charged with 5. Robbie Ross with the 0-1. And a hard ground ball to second. Holt has it, throws to first. Finally, the side retired. But not before 13 men can fly to right. Still a lot of time, but a 6-run deficit. And the lefty hits the inside edge. A call strike with a fastball at 95. Hanley to follow, then Shaw. Straub came out of the bullpen, got Ortiz to ground into a double play to end the fifth. Tall lefty fires, and a strike right in there. He took it down the middle. Getting his first look at the lefty from West Fargo, North Dakota. West Fargo, North Dakota, the home of the great Roger Maris. The 0-2, pass ball high. He was born in Minnesota, but grew up in Fargo. One and two to Mookie. Strom deals, and he jumps over the top of it, falls down, but avoids getting hit. He bounced that one, 2-2. Red Sox season ticket holder, experience the best seats, price, and benefits Fenway has to offer, including potential postseason opportunities. Go to RedSox.com/season tickets. 2-2 pitch. Up and away. I think Perez got crossed up by that pitch, but he caught it anyway. 3-2.
Well, that sixth inning, Joe, the highest singles inning, highest scoring single inning for the Royals this year with 8 runs.
3-2. Pop foul, backing out of play. The Royals are last in the league in runs scored.
If they have not had an 8-run inning. They've had 2 7-run innings this year. Again, for the Red Sox, clarify, this is their second worst inning where they gave up 11 runs to the Angels in the 7th on July 2nd.
And Mookie checks on a pitch down and away. No, he went, says the first base umpire. Mookie trots back to the dugout with his head down. He never argues. John Farrell's arguing. He's barking at the first base umpire. Eric Cooper is looking in the dugout. It was close. Here's Hanley now grounded out into a 6-3 double play and line to right. Those 4 double plays looming large now. Call strike to Hanley. Fastball in there. Matt Strom ready for the 0-1. There it is. Taken high.
Back for the Royals, Joe. It's been over 2 years since they scored 8 runs in an inning. Back to August 5th, 2014, they had 8 in a game against Arizona.
Strahm, the rookie, spells it S-T-R-A-H-M. Had Tommy John surgery, missed most of the 14 season. That's low. Toronto 1, Baltimore 1. And you got to look at the teams behind in the wild card. Detroit lost, Houston lost, Seattle lost. So did the Yankees. Kansas City winning here. 2-1. And he chased one away. Fastball with good movement. Probably not a strike. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Gravishaw to follow. Four-year-old lefty ready. And a foul to the backstop on a high heater. Red Sox have lost three of their last four after that good start to the trip. Two-two pitch. And a hard ground ball right to the shortstop. Escobar gobbles it up, throws to first. Low, Hosmer picks. Oh, he's so good. He really can flash that leather at first base. Eric Hosmer.
He just saved an error. Escobar with a rare bad throw. He doesn't make a lot of bad throws, but that one was a bad throw.
He had plenty of time.
Hosmer, yeah, he did. And Hosmer made a great play.
Now Travis Shaw walked into the fly to fairly deep right. Ten-4 Royals in the last of the six with two out and the bases empty. This kid's very impressive. Strahm fires in there for a strike. That's all they need is another bullpen arm, huh?
Yeah, right. Rich getting richer.
And remember, their prime closer was Greg Holland, and he had Tommy John, did not pitch in the postseason last year, not pitching all of this year. Then Wade Davis, who was lights out, low and away. He's on the DL. They lost Hochaver, who's been very good. He had thoracic surgery. He won't pitch again this year. But they keep replacing one bullpen arm with another. Herrera's now the closer, the pitch. Breaking ball in for a strike. And really, they've set a trend with bullpens, the bullpen arms. That's the largest single reason they won it all last year and came within one out of winning it all in 14, the pitch. Check swing. Did he foul it? Nope, he didn't swing either, says the third base umpire. 2-2.
The Red Sox breaking that long string of scoreless innings. 41 and a third innings of scoreless baseball they pitched this year.
2-2 outside.
And that is the longest streak since the Kansas City A's bullpen went 44 scoreless innings in 1966.
It's tough to figure because those Kansas City A's teams are terrible.
Yeah.
3-2. Weak ground ball hit wide at first. Hosmer has it. Leads the pitcher. Close but out. And that does it. A 1-2-3 inning after 6. 10-4.
Coming across Kansas City's highest scoring single inning in over 2 years. And here is Escobar, right-handed batter facing Robbie Ross, the left-hander. Here's the pitch. And it's curveball in for a strike. Escobar, 266 hitter. Three homers, 39 runs batted in, batting eighth in the Kansas City order. Walked in the second inning, popped up to Holt in the fourth, and had an infield single and scored a run in the sixth. Fouls this one off to the right. And the count is 0-2. So the Red Sox just hoping to settle things down here. Keep the score right where it is until they can get back to the plate in the bottom of the inning. The pitch swung on and a ground ball left side. Backhanded play by Bogarts. Throws across his body low. It is picked by Ramirez at first base. And Escobar is out. One down for Kansas City. And a nice finish by Hanley Ramirez
Bogaerts had to go to his right several steps toward the hole. Made the backhand catch on the run, and while still on the move, had to throw strongly across his body, which he did. Got a lot on it, but it bounced. And Hanley was there for the scoop. And there is one down. Raul Mondesi, the hitter. Boy, did he have a big hit in the sixth. Bases clearing triple. He had a sacrifice bunt back in the second inning that proved key to scoring a run. And he's grounded out to short. He swings and misses. He is a switch hitter, batting right-handed. Nothing in one as he chased the curveball. Hitting 191. But when he gets on the bases, he can fly. Pitch is swung on, fouled out of the glove of Sandy Leon. Count 0-2. But Robbie Ross getting ahead of both hitters he's faced so far this inning. No balls and two strikes. Retired Escobar and a ground ball out. He's got Mondesi at the plate, 0-2. Robbie on the first base side of the rubber comes set. The pitch swung on, pitch inside, and he fouled it off. Pulled it over near the Royals dugout. Well, the Royals at one point this season were scratching their heads and wondering where they'd be. This pitch has popped up. First baseman Hanley Ramirez in fair ground right next to the bag near the cut of the grass makes the catch. And that is out number two. So two down in the top half of the seventh inning. But the Royals were asking themselves where they would be come this time of the year, especially after the month of July they had. 7-19. Just a terrible month. After a losing month in June at 13-14. The pitch. And this one's fouled off by Paulo Orlando. Orlando hit by a pitch in the sixth inning, came around to score. He had a sacrifice fly and an RBI back in the second inning. 0-2 otherwise. Well, this Royals team went on a run here in mid-August toward the latter part of this month. They've still been playing exceptionally well. And a ground ball to the left side, charging as Shaw gets a good hop off the grass, throws to first. It's up the line a little toward home plate. Hanley tags him on the way by. And it's a 1-2 start. The Red Sox half of the seventh. Red Sox trailing 10-4. 10 runs on 9 hits for Kansas City. 4 runs, 7 hits for Boston. Each team with an error. And Young takes a strike. Young 2-for-2 had an infield single in the second inning. And he singled and scored a run in the fifth. The balls had one strike. Strom, the lefty set. He works the third base side of the rubber. Kicking the pitch. Inside and low, a fastball at 94. This is the third time this month the Royals have had 10 runs in a game. They only reached double digits 4 times in the first 4 months of the season. 1-1. That's low. 2 balls and a strike. So these high run totals, kind of a new thing for the Royals this year. So they struggle to score runs through a lot of the season. 2-1 pitch, pops it back, that'll be up on the roof of the press box and well out of play. 2 balls and 2 strikes to Chris Young. Matt Strom gets a new baseball back, ready to dig in on the rubber. Bent over at the waist, his left arm hanging down by his side. He shakes off the first sign from Perez, accepts the second, now comes set, 2-2. And Young pops this one up, playable, right side. Drifting into foul ground is the first baseman, Hosmer. Now he backpedals, and that ball goes back into fair ground. And it is caught for out number one. So Young flies out to Eric Hosmer. And there's one down for Sandy Leon. This summer, pump up the fun with Irving Oil's $5 million giveaway. Collect to win $100,000, instantly win $5,000, or play online to win $25,000. Get your game ticket today. Visit IrvingFun.com for details. Leon, switch hitter, batting right-handed. Swings, fouls the first pitch back. That is strike one to Sandy. Sandy is 0-for-2. Fly to left field in the second inning and then reached on an error by center fielder Paulo Orlando when he gator armed a fly ball that was hit to him in deep center field. Sandy will take a pitch up high here, and it's 1-1. Don't forget, tomorrow, tune into WEEI starting at 6 a.m. here in Boston for the beginning of the Jimmy Fund Radio Telethon. A swing and a miss. And there are a lot of ways to donate. And we'll be talking about the Jimmy Fund. And bringing you a number of folks who've been affected by the insidious disease and how the Jimmy Fund is helping them, doctors. And we'll have a lot of stories for you over the next couple of days here. 1-2 pitch. That is up high. Two balls and two strikes. More information about the Jimmy Fund, www.jimmyfund.org. And a pitch inside and low to Sandy, 3-2. And tomorrow and Tuesday, I'll be giving out the phone number and the text number. Phone number 877-738-1234 to donate. You can text KCANCER to 20222 to donate $25. We'll start telling you more about that tomorrow morning and all night. Next couple of nights, Sandy walks. So the Red Sox with a runner aboard and one out. The WEEI Nesson Jimmy Fund Radio Telethon starting tomorrow morning, 6 a.m. Make sure you keep your radio on here on the Red Sox flagship station. You will hear some of the most compelling stories. Jackie Bradley Jr. looks out, and Strom delivers on the outside corner for a strike. A left-on-left matchup here. Middle infield looks for two. Outfield pretty much straight up for Jackie, who has a hit tonight. He swings and fists this one foul back to the screen off to the left. 0-2 to Bradley. Singled in the third inning in his first at bat, then walked and scored in the Red Sox 3-run fifth. That looked like that was going to be a very good inning, and it was up until the top of the sixth, which kind of countered it, and then some. Pitches lined hard and foul down the left field side, bouncing into the stands and then out. No balls, two strikes to JBJ. Jackie's average up to 273. Short lead at first base by Sandy Leon. Stretched by Strom, and the lefty's pitch is up high, and the count 1-2. Getting closer to that September 1st mark. Still a few more days to go before Major League rosters expand. The pitch outside, 2-2. Minor league seasons will go till Labor Day Monday. They'll finish up then. But the Red Sox probably have a good idea by now who they want to bring up. 2-2. Swung on, popped up, left side, back a third. Short left field now. The shortstop takes over. Escobar, he will make the catch close to the left field line. And there are two out for the Red Sox now in the bottom of the seventh inning. With MLB.TV Premium, the number one live streaming sports service, watch every out-of-market game live in HD on over 400 supported devices. It includes a free subscription to At-Bat Premium, the number one app for live baseball. Blackout and other restrictions apply. Visit MLB.TV for details. Bottom of the seventh, 10-4 Kansas City. And Brock Holt, who is 1-for-3 with an RBI tonight, hit into a double play in the third. Infield back with two down. Not all the way on the left side, though. Escobar playing in a little shallow for the left-handed hitting Holt, who takes a strike. The Royals have double barrel action in the bullpen. Brian Flynn, a lefty. Peter Moylan, a right-hander. And the pitch in right at the knees to Holt for strike two. No balls and two strikes. Red Sox have another possible Sunday night game, though there has been no determination yet on it. Pitches up high. You'd think the target would be the 18th of September here at Fenway Park against the Yankees. That has not been announced as a Sunday night telecast yet. Right now, still TBD.
Well, it was a big game in Toronto on a Sunday, but they don't televise from Toronto usually.
1-2 is outside. 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Yeah, they never do.
Yeah, that would be on, well, the next weekend, the 25th. That's a getaway day for us, Joe, and it's a 110 game, and it'd be great if it would stay that way. There's a ground ball to the right side, and Mondesi, back on the edge of the outfield grass, makes the play, throws out Holt. And the Red Sox done in the seventh. We head to the eighth at Fenway Park in Boston. It is Kansas City. Game will start an hour earlier than tonight's do. Junichi Tozawa comes out of the bullpen. He replaces Robbie Ross Jr. Robbie went an inning and two thirds, gave up 2 hits. But his final inning of work in the top of the seventh, he had a clean inning, 2 ground balls and a pop-up. And Tozawa facing Chesler Cuthbert, the third baseman. He starts him off with a strike and a curveball. Tozawa threw an inning Friday night against Kansas City. Gave up a hit and an earned run. It was a home run that he gave up. And a pitch on the way, and that is fouled back. Lorenzo Cain hit a home run off of him on Friday. For Tozawa, 2-2, 489 earned run average. This is his 47th appearance. The opposition hitting 251 against him. Nothing and two to Cuthbert. Stretched by Taz in the 0-2 pitch. Bounced at the plate. 1 ball and 2 strikes. Well, a lot of what was a sellout crowd starting to head to the streets on a Sunday night. Red Sox down by 6. Here is the 1-2 pitch. It's bounced again at the plate. Tried the splitter, and it was a foot in front of home plate. Skipped past Sandy Leon to the backstop. Eduardo Rodriguez tonight, 5 1/3. Gave up 5 earned runs. 4 hits. He walked 4, and the 4 walks were ill-timed. There usually are. But Matt Barnes tonight, a tough outing. Did not record an out and gave up 5 earned runs. Cuthbert fouls it wide a third. 3 hits for Barnes. Again, didn't make a third of an inning. Robbie Ross had to come in and take over. He gave up 2 hits, and the inning continued. Those runs were charged to Barnes. It scored off the Ross hits. And Ross 1 2/3, but not charged for any runs. 2 balls and 2 strikes to the right-handed hitting Cuthbert. Taz deals 2-2. Swung on, foul tipped into the glove of Sandy Leon for strike 3. Cuthbert down on strike. Second time he has gone down swinging. And a strikeout for Tozawa. Let's pause now 10 seconds. To allow our stations to identify themselves on the Shaw's WEEI Red Sox Radio Network.
This is Sports Radio 93.7 WEEI FM and HD1, Lawrence, Boston.
Here's Lorenzo Cain facing Tozawa for the second time in this series. First time did not end well for Tozawa. 1-0 is the fastball missed. Cain up to 288 with 9 homers and 54 runs batted in. The right fielder looking out at Tozawa. Stretch kick and the pitch. And that's on the inside edge for a strike. 1 ball, 1 strike. Top of the eighth. Third and final game of this series. It'll be the final game of the season between these two teams. Ready for the 1-1. And it is a pitch low. A check swing. They appeal to first, and Eric Cooper rings up a strike. 1 ball and 2 strikes. By By the time the Royals land in Kansas City, it'll be between 4 and 5 in the morning, Kansas City time, and then they'll start a series at home tomorrow night. And they've got a bunch of home games remaining. That's a big benefit for them. 20 of their final 32 games will be at home.
And they're really good at home and struggle on the road.
1-2 up and in and under the chin, and that backs Kane out of the box. So Kansas City putting on a late season surge. Still have a way to go to catch Cleveland. Two ball, two strike pitch. And this one is popped up right side of the infield. Hanley Ramirez getting underneath it. He'll make the catch for the second out here in the eighth. Kansas City's best opportunity is with a wild card where they're just 3.5 out as we sit and talk now.
Well, a win tonight would leave them 5.5 behind Cleveland. Cleveland's been stumbling a little bit lately.
And of those 32 games they have remaining, six are against Minnesota, who has found remarkable ways to lose games this year. Eric Hosmer takes high and in. One ball, no strikes.
Today they lost their 10th in a row.
Yeah, it's a shame what's happening in Minnesota. But other teams just beating up on them. And a lot of times I think the Twins would agree they beat themselves. Stretch by Taz in the 1-0 pitch. Swung on and a bouncer to first. Backing up on it is Hanley. He'll take it himself. And it's a 1-2-3, top of the eighth. Clean inning for Junichi Tozawa. Moylan gets set on the hill, the right-hander. Delivering with a drop-down motion. Not quite a side armor. Really a low three-quarter arm slot. Making his 33rd appearance. 3.73 his ERA, the 0-1 to Xander. He swings and hits a one hopper. Backhand by Cuthbert. He spins, throws to first, and gets Xander. Wow, what a play by Chesler Cuthbert at third. One out for the Red Sox in the eighth. Bogaerts out 5-3. David Ortiz has had kind of an up and down night. A home run in the fourth that got the Red Sox on the board. Made it a 2-1 ball game at that point. But he's hit into two double plays. And the chance of Poppy. Poppy all around Fenway Park as Moylan delivers a strike on the outside corner. About knee high. Nothing and one to Ortiz, hitting 319. 31 home runs. 101 runs batted in. The 0-1 pitch. And David fouls this one off. David's probably going to finish with more than 34 home runs. Darrell Evans, the oldest player, or the only player 40-plus, to have more than that. He had 34. He finished his 40-year-old season with 34 home runs. So if David has more than that, he'll be the 40-year-old with the most home runs ever in Major League history. He's going to finish with a lot of high numbers. One ball and two strikes to Ortiz. 534 career home runs for David. Royals infield shifted to the right. Moreland's pitch. Low and in. And it's 2-2. Two balls and two strikes to Ortiz. Moreland set at the belt. The right-hander ready to come home now. Here's the pitch, and David swings and strikes out. So he goes down on strikes. David 1-for-4. And this will bring up Mookie Betts. Betts batting with two out, nobody on. Moreland's just tough. Part of this tough Kansas City bullpen. we've talked about him. Teams around Major League Baseball have had to experience this year.
But yeah, people go down, they keep replacing them with somebody just as good.
It's amazing how they just, it's like the deli counter, you know, they call the number and they say next, and here he is. Next man up philosophy. Slider into Betts for a strike. Right on right matchup here. The 0-1 from Moylan. And it's way outside. One ball and one strike. Moylan opened the ninth inning Friday night in game one here. He allowed consecutive base hits to Dustin Pedroia and Xander Bogaerts. And Kelvin Herrera came in for him after that. The 1-1. And Mookie bounces it to third. Cuthbert back of the bag along the line, makes the catch, throws off target to first base. And Mookie Betts steps on the bag. Hosmer thought he didn't. He went back and touched it. And now he's talking to first base umpire Eric Cooper, who called him safe. It was going to be a very, very close play. So see if that's a hit or a throwing error, as Cuthbert's throw was offline. But Mookie might have beaten it anyway.
Should give him a hit.
I don't think so. I think it was close enough. They are giving him a base hit. So Betts with another multi-hit game. He's 2 for 4.
56 multiple hit games and 176 hits.
Don't forget to stay tuned for the Sunoco post-game show. The Sunoco Free Fuel 5000. Get the decal, get spotted, win. So here is Hanley Ramirez. Mookie Betts off of first base. Moylan set now the pitch, and that's inside for a ball. So that's the third hit to a right-handed batter he's allowed in this series. Betts gets the base hit. Now a bouncer toward Hosmer. He'll make the play. They'll go for the force at second base with Escobar covering. And that will do it for the Red Sox. And a quiet eighth. No runs, one hit, one left. We'll head to the ninth inning with the score. Kansas City 10, Boston.
Here's Morales. Fly to right. Reached on an error by the starter Rodriguez. Double to right and single, both in the sixth inning. Ball one. Two hits in the 8-run sixth inning. Royals' biggest inning in 2 years. Holt back and right in the shift. And the pitch. Breaking ball, missing outside. E-Rod on the hook, 5 1/3, 5 runs, only 4 hits, but 4 big walks. 2-0. Popped up foul, third base side, out of play. And Matt Barnes did not retire a batter. He faced 5 men, 5 runs, 3 hits, a hit batsman. There was a fielder's choice as well. Joaquin Soria getting loose. He's really turned his season around, pitching very well during this great run by the Kansas City bullpen. 2-1 deal, and a foul grounded to the backstop. Used to be their prime closer. 2-2. Taz deals, and a little dribbler up the first base line. He kicks foul. The Royals enter this game 14 under on the road. They win tonight, they'll be 28 and 41. They've been dominated at home where they're going. Forty and 21 at home. Taz with a 2-2. And a ground ball foul again by the Red Sox dugout, hit softly.
So Koji Uehara take that foul ball and toss it up into the seats. And I know that he's on the road back.
He's going to pitch the hitters tomorrow. Instead of another bullpen, he's going to pitch the hitters in pregame. 2-2. Ground ball beating the shift in a left field, a base hit. Third baseman was on the right side. He hit it where the third baseman might have had it. And that is three hits tonight for Morales. Here's Salvi Perez, who homered to get the scoring started in the second inning. A solo shot leading off. Fly to left. Walked. A big walk in that eight-run sixth, and then he grounded out 5-3 later in the sixth. He'll get a pinch runner here for Morales. Billy Burns. He's the keeper of the Praying Mantis. Has deals and a ground ball left side. Shaw has it, flips to second, high throw and out. No chance for two because of the high throw. Looked like a double play ball with a slow footed Perez going. But Shaw's throw is high into the inside part of second base. So a 5-4 force, no error. And now Alex Gordon, who's single, grounded out 3-1, fly to left, and grounded out 4-3. He actually made two outs in that sixth inning.
Nobody wants to be that guy when you bat around.
That's right.
Oftentimes you make the first out and the last out, but nobody wants to be that guy.
There were 22 minutes between the first out and second out. Two pitching changes, foul to the left, out of play. The Royals go home for the Yankees, and the Red Sox welcome Tampa Bay tomorrow night. First night of our Jimmy Fund radio telethon. It's Rick Porcello against Matt Andrees. And for the second night of the Jimmy Fund radio telethon, Drew Pomerantz and Jake Odorizzi. He was very tough, pitch missing low. And then Wednesday afternoon, a 1:35 game, Stephen Wright versus Drew Smyly. And they shift on Gordon as they did on Morales. And he misses inside with a fastball. It's almost a three-hour flight to Kansas City. They do gain an hour, but they're looking at a very early morning arrival. Taz deals 2-1, and a good changeup swung on and missed.
A couple of guys from the Royals I was talking with today, Joe, said, you guys do this a lot on Sunday night. We don't do this very much, so how do you deal with those overnight flights? You just do.
They probably have the easiest travel in the AL Central because of cities in close proximity. 2-2, low and away. It's probably not the flight that's as long as 2 hours between Cleveland, Detroit, Kansas City, Chicago, Minnesota.
A lot of quick flights.
Generally thought that teams going west to east have it the roughest. 3-2 pitch. And a ground ball snapped by Taz, throws to the bag, grabbed by Bogarts on the first double play. Nicely done by Xander with a throw that was to the third base side. A second one, 6-3, and we go to the bottom of the... Here's Travis Shaw, who walked, fly to right, and grounded out 3-1. Moreland, one inning, no runs, a hit in the K. Soria deals and drills a strike in there. His best pitch now is his changeup. Soria hasn't pitched since Thursday in Miami. He's made 10 straight scoreless appearances dating back to August 5th. And it's Loya's 203 career saves, the most among Mexican-born players. And in his career, opponents hitting just 217 against them. He's third in Royals history in relief outings. This is number 355. Foul to the left out of play. Jeff Montgomery does some broadcasting for them. 686 and the late great Dan Quisenberry pitched in 573 games. Part of their 85 World Championship team. One and two to Travis. Soria's pitch fouled again left side. 37,337. Many have departed. And there's a weak ground ball. The first base line. Grabbed by Hosmer. On the hands of the pitcher. Close but out. Shaw 3-1. And it brings up Young, who's had two infield hits to third and then a pop to first. And the Royals with a late season push. On August 6th, they were 7 under .500, 51-58, 11 games out, 9.5 back in the wild card. Call strike to Young, and with a win here, they will be only 5.5 behind Kansas City. And at a virtual tie with Detroit for second in the... Let's see. No, Detroit remains 4.5 out. Detroit lost today. So there'll be one behind Detroit for second in the Central, 5.5 behind Cleveland. Young takes it very high. They've won 16 of 20. They've cut 4.5 games off their divisional deficit. This would make it 5.5 by shaving 6.5 off the wild card. And he missed down, 3-2.
Well, certainly quite a run they've been on, and now that they've figured out how to score runs in recent games, too, yeah, that could make them a pretty dangerous team as you get into next month, final month of the season.
Tap foul. They'll be getting Wade Davis back, so their bullpen be even stronger. They keep finding people like Strom. Been lights out. 2-2. Check swing strike over the outside corner. Down he goes looking. Two down in the ninth. On a disappointing night for the Red Sox. And it brings up Sandy Leon, who is wide to left, reached on a two-base error by the center fielder Orlando and drawn a walk. Strom's game to win. And Erod on the hook. He'd be 2-6. Heard rusty tonight, especially with his command. Call strike. Sandy takes a curve a little low. Red Sox would stay one ahead of Baltimore. They won today. Got two behind Toronto, the pitch. Fastball in for a strike. So it's 1-2. And the 1-2 poked down the left field side, foul into the stands. This game approaching the 3.5 hour mark.
Thought you were talking about the sixth inning.
Yeah. There's a little fly ball dropping into left center field, and Gordon dives. He trapped it. Came straight ahead and trapped it. So a hit for Sandy. That breaks an 0-4-13 for Sandy. He'll take it. Two out in, and JBJ coming up. Single walked, popped to short. He scored a run.
The biggest
single blow in that sixth inning was a three-run triple by young Raul Mondesi, the 21-year-old. Raul Mondesi Jr. Jackie fouls it to the backstop, strike one. Now 10 runs earned. Perez visiting the mound. Perez was set up away, and that was an inside fastball. Soria's 0-1. That's low. Brock Holt on deck. John Farrell told us that Dustin Pedroia is due back around game time tomorrow, leaving for a family funeral today. Here's the pitch. And that's high. 2-1 with the runner at first and two men down. We're in the ninth. Jackie swings and misses at a low splitter. Two balls, two strikes, two out. Red Sox have hit into four double plays in this one. That hurt early. So are you ready? His pitch. It's high. So he's gone to 3-2. With two out in the night, if he reaches, Holt would be next. So a surprising number of Kansas City shirts around town and in the stands. Those fans traveling. 3-2. Low and away, ball four. Jackie takes a two-out walk. And here is Holt, who was 1-for-4, singled in the first. Did get an RBI and a ground out in the fifth.
Yeah, the Royals do have a good following. And, you know, their attendance and their fan following has gone through the roof in Kansas City since they started the win 2 years ago. And then, of course, the World Series victory. But being in two World Series in a row, they have fans everywhere, and they've come out of the woodwork.
Fastball in for a strike.
I agree. I've seen a lot of Royals jerseys this weekend around town. Walked around the last couple of mornings, and today walked around the city a lot. Saw a bunch of Royals stuff.
That's good to see, because they were struggling for so many years outside. They didn't make postseason after they won the World Series in 85 until 2014. Which is remarkable. Baseball has come back in the city of fountains. The pitch way high and away, 2-1. So sorry, having a little trouble commanding here. And Salvi Perez visits the mound.
He's hearing about it.
Get their closer up, Kelvin Herrera. It's 10-4 with two on, two out.
I'm sure that's the last thing that Yost really wanted to do, is get Herrera up in the pen. Just
this late in the ball game. He wants certainly Sorey to finish up.
Two-one pitch coming to Brock, and he takes a fastball in for a strike. Oh, that was very hittable, right down the middle at 93. Two balls, two strikes, two out, two on in the ninth. The pitch to Holt, and he fouls it straight back. Been a long one primarily because of that 38-minute top of the sixth. And the Royals set 13 men to the plate, eight of them scored. Sorey is 2-2. Swing and a miss, strike three. It is over. Kansas City Royals with eight in the sixth beat the Red Sox 10-4. The Red Sox are now two behind first place Toronto in the American League's Eastern Division race.